Let's talk about a smarter approach. Our first goal doesn't need to be maximize the value for the largest weight possible. What if we tried to maximize the value for the smallest weights possible, then kept adding them together until we had our maximum weight? Let's look at an example. We start by creating an array, which we'll use to store the maximum possible value for every weight up into our weight limit. We assume that the weights are all positive integers, so the indices in the array represent those weights. We initialize everything to zero for now. These are our objects that we're trying to fit in a knapsack with a weight limit of 6. We take out the object with a weight of 2. We can update the value at index 2 to the value of the object. Then we'll update everything after it as well with the same value. Even if our knapsack can hold 6, we've only seen one object so far, so we need to base that best value off one object. We look at the next object. Again, we can't change anything until index 5. The value of this object is bigger than the max, and it takes up the whole weight, so we replace the max value for weights 5 and 6. For the last object, the first thing we could possibly change is index 4. This value is less than that one, so we leave it alone. We look at index 5 and compare it to our value plus the value at index 1. Since the old value is larger, we leave it as is. At index 6, we add our object value to the value at index 2 and end up with a bigger value, so we replace it. And we've solved the problem. This may seem unnecessary with an example this small, but imagine how much time we'll save with lots of objects. Here, we're taking advantage of the table to store pre-computed maximum values. So we only need to do the work once to get those numbers. We go through every object and check if it can increase the maximum value of every possible weight up to our maximum weight. Thus, the runtime is n times w, where w is the weight limit of our knapsack and n is the number of elements. This is a pseudo-polynomial time solution. A true polynomial runtime wouldn't have a variable besides n. I reiterate, polynomial time algorithms are much faster than exponential time algorithms for big numbers, so the solution here is generally faster.